My name is Robert Alberts. I'm the coach of Persib Bandung. It is Wednesday, the 21st of August, and with me I have a letter from the disciplinary committee of PSSI. One of our players, Ariono, got a letter today that he's suspended for the next match in. We're going to Lampung, and this letter really took us by surprise. As you will see later in the video clip, Ariono did a mistake. He got an offense inside our box. He made a foul. He was punished for that by the referee with a card, and also we got a penalty against us. What the point here is that he was punished, the referee gave a penalty, and there was no foul play, there was no dirty play. He went up to the ball, as you can see in the video, and the opponent came towards him. There was no other incidents, there was no dirty kicks, there was no after kick, and the referee did the right thing, awarded a penalty. We don't complain against that, but this makes everybody really confused, because what will happen now is anyone that gets a free kick can suddenly get a suspension, whereas the referee already has given the correct decision by giving a penalty and a card to the player. But now we get suspensions, the player, just 2 days before or 3 days before we play the next match. And this is a very dangerous situation, because in principle everyone can get now a punishment after a foul that is deemed to be within the limits, because the referee give a penalty, the referee don't give a red card. But after that we get punished more again, and this is something that really needs to be addressed by all parties in football in Indonesia, because the referee has made the decision. If the referee has overlooked anything, like a dirty kick behind or an elbow in the face, we all agree that should not be part of the game, and that can be punished after, but not in this incident where it is very clear we made a foul, Ariono was punished, but after that we get more punishment, and we are asking ourselves what could the reason be for this, because it is not logical that it is happening like this, and it should not happen. So I hope this will bring up a debate what is right and wrong in giving disciplinary action after the referee has taken his action. And then the club can't even complain about this, because it is stated in the letter we cannot put any protest. But the player is suspended and the club will lose another player for the next match. So I hope this small interview on the social media can bring up the debate, is this right or wrong?